fear. We are Americans just like you.
Defiance to the White House's executive order on sanctuary cities comes not just from the streets, but from city mayors. Chicago.
But I want to be clear, we're going to stay a sanctuary city.
Boston.
If necessary, will we use City Hall itself to shelter and protect anyone who's targeted unjustly?
Los Angeles.
You can't use federal money as a gun to the head to change some other policies.
LA's mayor says federal funds weave through nearly all city services, law enforcement, schools, veterans care.
I'm talking to all mayors in this country.
Are the mayors going to unite to draw a line in the sand?
We have. We want the federal government to protect those folks who've gotten temporary legal status, and we want the overall system to be fixed.
One thing that many mayors of sanctuary cities say is broken, undocumented immigrants being held in local jails until federal authorities come to deport them. Many cities argue the extended detention is unconstitutional and costly. Trump's executive order demands cities follow federal rules or federal funds will stop. The president is fulfilling a campaign promise after the death of Kate Steinle. She was killed by an undocumented immigrant released from a local jail in San Francisco, even though federal agents targeted him for deportation.
For these families, it's been one injustice after another. But that all turns around beginning today.
Some estimates more than 300 cities and counties are so-called sanctuary cities. While it's unclear exactly what federal funding the order would cut, San Francisco estimates it receives $1 billion in federal funds. New York, nearly $9 billion. New York's mayor telling CNN if Trump pulls funding, his next punch will come in court.
If an attempt is made to do that, we will go to court immediately for an injunction to stop it.